Welcome to my video, French Pronunciation, the Scientific Way Using IPA, the International Phonetic Alphabet. I found this chart on the internet. It's a joke. Some people say French pronunciation is complicated because there are a lot of silent consonants and a lot of vowels that sound not like the way they're supposed to sound. But we're going to see that once you know a bit of rules, it's not that complicated. So, I'm going to introduce you to the International Phonetic Alphabet. Why would I need an alphabet for phonetic? I could do a recording of my voice, but it would change depending on my accent and it would be an audio file. It's not an alphabet. It's not something you can write. It's a written form of pronunciation. And when we talk about, when you use this alphabet, we use two little bars or two little brackets like this. Let's take a French word, mangeons. As you can see, there are eight letters in mangeons, but there are only four sounds, two consonant sounds and two vowel sounds. Let's take another example, Russie. Here we have the French R. Beurre, here we also have the French R. Élève, here we see that we introduce accent to change the way a vowel is pronounced. Premier, okay. So those symbols, they are used by a lot of people. They are used in dictionaries. So either real dictionaries, either online dictionaries, as we can see later. They are used for all the languages, including English, and they are very useful to compare pronunciation between words or languages. For example, the R in the accent of German from Germany, it's the same as the standard French R. When studying French, I think the most difficult thing is vowel. The first vowel is the sound E. It can be written with the letter I or the letter Y. So, for example, we have ici, vie, lyrique. It's easy because in English you have the sound E, but that's always long. It's the E sound in heel or bead. On the left I have a sound in French words, and on the right I have the closest equivalent in English. Because sometimes there are sounds that are not in the English language, but that exist in French. And in IPA, the two dots mean longer time. So in English, the E sound is always long. Then we have the letter E. In French, that's the letter E. It can, of course, be pronounced E, like in le or premier. In English, you have a bird, above, over, open. When you put an accent, like here, when you put an accent in that direction, from right to left, it's called an acute accent. And it changed the sound from E to E. In words like été, jouer, j'ai, it's the E sound. In English, you have B. Then, if the accent is in the opposite direction, if it's a grave accent, the sound is not E, the sound is E, like in set. In words like faire, être, merci, jouer, lait. As you can see, in jouer or j, or jouer or lait, two letters can be for one sound. The letter E can be combined with the letter U to form the E sound, like in peu or de. In English, you have like urgent, firm, work. And sometimes the letter EU can be pronounced er, like in cœur peur, cueillir. The next letter is the letter A. The letter A is pronounced A, like in amour, plat. It's close to cat in English. When there is a circumflex accent, that's the accent that looks like a hat, it's the sound A, like in part, ba. In English, you have this sound. It's like after. The letter O can be pronounced in two different ways. Either the open O, like in or, om. Either the closed O, like in mot, gauche, O, hôpital. I'm not going to do the English equivalent. Finally, if you see OU, it's the OU sound, like in genou. It's the same as boom in English, but shorter. And finally, the letter U is not called U, it's called U. It's a sound you don't have in English. And the IPA is this letter, this symbol. Okay, so I told you that there are some vowels that do not exist in English. So how do you pronounce them? Well, there are three characteristics for a vowel. And they are all in this graph, in this drawing, called the vowel trapezium. It's related to where the mouth, where in the mouth the sound comes from. The first characteristic is if the vowel is closed or open. If it's closed, it means the mouth is closed and that the tongue is a bit rounded. The tongue is a bit rounded. So, for example, E, it's the closest vowel. E, when you do a E, you don't really open your mouth. But when you do a A, you open your mouth a lot, and your tongue is a bit flat. If I say these four vowels, I, E, E, A, if I say it in one time, yeah, my mouth is opening a bit. As more as I say, yeah, yeah. Okay, there are some sounds that are only in French, in both French and English, and only in English. The second characteristic is if the vowel is in front of your mouth or in the back of your mouth. In the front means that the tongue is touching your teeth. For example, when I say I, it's touching the teeth. When I say U, the tip of my tongue is not touching my teeth. The back vowel in French are OO, O, A. Again, I said them OO, O, A when opening my mouth. The third characteristic is the roundness of the lips. For example, when you say E, your lips are not rounded. But when you say OO, when you say OO or O, your lips are rounded. It's very easy to see on the lips when someone is doing an E or doing an OO. But OO is a back vowel. In French, we have a front vowel that is rounded lips and very close. It's the U sound. So EU. When I say EU, the only thing that changes are my rounded lips. EU. Here we have EU. And A does not have a rounded version in French. Here are other vowels that exist in English. So in French we have O. It's rounded. And in English, you have this sound like in up and down. It's the same, up, but unrounded. Up, up, oh, up, oh. And again, in French and English, we have the ah sound, and you have the hot song, oh. Finally, we have the schwa, the e sound, that is center and center. It's just you open your mouth and you say e. And here are three vowels on the trapezium that you have in English. E, U, E. Another difficulty comes from the nasal vowel. It's like a normal vowel, like E, but the airflow comes from your nose. There are a lot of videos that can teach you how to do them. Now I'm just going to say to you the four vowel. Un is the nasal vowel of E. Un is the nasal vowel of E. En is the nasal vowel of A. And on is the nasal vowel of O. So we have un, on, en, on. The first one can be written with IN, EIN, or AIN. So we have sapin, plein, pain. The second one can be written with UN, like un or brun. The third one can be written with AN or EN, like en, pendant. And the fourth one can be written with ON, like un, bonbon. There are a lot of videos that give tricks for pronouncing nasal vowel. Of course, we have some consonants. They are mostly the same as in English, except for the P, for example, that is not with air. We would say papa, we would not say papa. The two-letter CH, it's like the SH in English, SH sound. So we have SHA, SHEMA, can also be written SCH. We have the J sound that you have also. It can be written with a J or with a G. J, genou. It's like in English, measure. You have the GN, ny. It's a bit like Kenyan. Agneau. And you have the French R. And you can find tricks online to teach you about how to say it. Renard. And of course, we have semi-consonants. So when there's consonants that only work when there is a vowel afterward. You have the Y sound, like yes in English, can be written with the letter Y, yaourt, when there is a vowel after, and can be also written with I-L-L, like in my. You have the W sound, like in wagon. It can come from the letters O-I that together becomes the W sound. So here it's joie. A W can happen from just the OU sound, oui, or noué. And then we have the W sound. It's like a U, but with a vowel. Will, lui. As we have seen, multiple letters can stand for one sound. So I'm going to give you a list of all the possible cases you can have. It's very useful when you read, because you have to memorize that to do the proper sound. First, we have simple letters. So remember that letters are not said in the same way that in English. This is A, E, I, O, U. You have digraphs, so when there are two letters forming one sound, or trigraphs, when you have three letters forming one sound. So AI is pronounced E, EU is pronounced E, EU can also be pronounced E, we don't know, we have to check. AU is pronounced O, EAU is pronounced O, OU is pronounced OU, and OI is pronounced WA. Some vowel change at the end. For example, AI at the end is not pronounced E, it's pronounced E. And ER is pronounced E, ET is pronounced E or E in some accent, and EZ is pronounced E also. Of course, we have the nasal, so remember IN is UN, EIN is also UN, AIN is also UN, UN is UN, AN is UN, EN is also on, and ON is on. Work on the difference. On, 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 on. And finally, the consonant CH is sh, SCH is sh, and GN is ny. And more on that later. Here are some handy reference. Of course, we have the Wikipedia page IPA for French and IPA for English that gives you a big table like I did. You have the dictionaries, like the word reference here, for one word. So here I have the word élève, and if I click on this link, I'm going to see that élève is written élève, indeed. It's not written, it's pronounced élève, but it's written in IPA like this. And I also like to use Wiktionary that does exactly the same thing, but with an audio file. And also much more information. So IPA, élève is élève. And here the dot indicates a difference between syllable. So élève has two syllables, é and lève. And if you want a big chart with all the phonetic alphabet symbols, you can click this link. Okay, here we have another, some spelling rules to help you pronounce things correctly. If you have an E at the end, it's mute. Don't say it. For example, here, école, we don't say école. We don't say école. Here we have journée. Here we have élève, aimé. If you say it, you will be understood, but you will sound a bit funny. École sounds funny. Okay. There are seven consonants that you don't say when they are at the end. It's mute, don't say it. The C, like in blanc, the D, like in grand, the G, like in sang, the P, like in beaucoup, the S, like in table, the T, like in chat, the X, like in hibou. Those seven consonants, when that's at the end of words, don't say it. But when there is a vowel afterward, a mute consonant becomes pronounced. The D is pronounced T when there is a vowel afterward. This phenomenon is called liaison. So we don't say, we say grand, we say homme, but we say grand homme. We say the P is pronounced P. We say trop, we say aimable, but we say trop aimable. The R is pronounced R. We say premier, we say enfant, but we say premier enfant. S becomes Z. We say les, we say euro, but we say les euros. And T is pronounced T. We say pot, we say eau, we say feu, but we say pot au feu. And X becomes Z. We say mieux, we say être, but we say mieux être. And if you have N in a nasal sound, you pronounce the N. For example, un, we say ami, but we say un ami. Why is this phenomenon happening is because we like to alternate between consonant and vowel. If we have vowel than a vowel, it's called a hiatus, and we don't like that. As you can see, I didn't mention the C and the G, Well, those, they don't have liaison. So we would say, for example, un blanc arbre. We won't say that. Forget that. It just have no liaison for C and G. We wouldn't say un blanc arbre, we say un arbre blanc. So my example is a bad example. For the example, another explanation, check liaison on Wikipedia. How is the C pronounced? When it's before E or I, it's pronounced S, like in ceci, seagull. But when it's before A, O, or U, it's pronounced K, like in curé, cadeau, and cord. If we don't want to have this, to pronounce like this, we can change it with S, with the cedilla. So if you see a C with a cedilla, it's always pronounced S. So we have déçu, ça, garçon. And of course, when it's at the end, it's mute. How to pronounce the G sound, the G letter? Before E and I, it's pronounced je, like in genou, giraffe. Before A, O, or U, it's pronounced g, like in gustatif, garage, gorille. If you want to change this phenomenon, you have to add a U if you want the g before, a g sound before E, before E or I. Mangue, guidé. And if you want a je sound before A or U, or A or O, you put a I, like in mangea, mangeon. Attention, it's not possible to have the je sound with the U. If you put, for example, this word, it's pronounced mangeur. And of course, if it's at the end, mute, don't say it. The pronunciation of the S, when it's at the end, mute, don't say it. When it's between two vowels, it's pronounced Z, like in maison. And otherwise, it's pronounced S, se, moisson, espérer. And finally, we have the H. In general, it's mute, don't say it. We don't pronounce H. There are two kinds of H, the normal H. So here this word habité, we say habité, hiver. It's a normal H. So we, because we don't say it, there is elision. So we don't say je habite, we say j'habite. We don't say le hiver, we say l'hiver. And there is liaison. We say en, we say habitant, but we say en habitant. We say un, we say hiver, but we say un hiver. And the second type of H is the aspirated H. In the dictionaries, you will see an apostrophe. In IPA, you will see an apostrophe for meaning that the H is aspirated. There is no way to know, other than looking at the dictionary, if a H is aspirated or not. And in that case, so here we have haricot and O, and in that case, there is no elision, so we don't say l'haricot, we say le haricot, we don't say l'eau, we say le eau. L'eau means something else, O means stop. And there is no liaison, so we don't say des haricots, we say des haricots. And we don't say en eau, we say en eau. Voilà, I hope you liked my video and you will not be afraid of the silent letter or the vowel combination that's on none of the vowel involved. See you next time.